Hello there, Matt with Limbit here. In this short demo, I'm going to show you a tool named Dearbity Top that Limbit developed to make viewing and managing large Dearbity deployments with lots of resources much easier than what was previously available. First, I'll show you the way we've done it in the past. This is the output of Dearbity ADM Status, the most commonly used utility for viewing your resources. Not very easy to quickly extract the big picture from this lengthy list. Then Dearbity Overview. It's another utility that ships with DRBD, and it gives you a more concise and compact view, but doesn't offer anything other than that. Now, here is DRBD Top. DRBD Top can be used to view as well as manage all your resources in a nice curses-based interface. You can also use it to drill down into a level of detail that was just not possible before through any other utilities we ship. We can see the states changing in real time. As we're viewing these resources, we saw R18 pop to primary and then back to secondary. And we'll see it again here while we're looking at the detailed view. And you see some of those statistics at the bottom there changing. And we'll drop out of this view, and then we'll use Dearbity Top to set this resource to the primary state by highlighting it. And then pressing R for roll and P for primary, you'll see it switch to primary there. Also, we can use this danger filter, which will allow us to look at only our resources that are deemed dangerous. They're in a non-ideal state. So we'll drop into R00 to see what's wrong, and we see that both were in standalone. This usually means a split brain has occurred, or resources just disconnected, but we hit M to drop into D message, and we quickly see the split brain detected but unresolved message in the logs. And we can resolve the split brain without leaving Dearbity Top, which is a nice feature. And we'll do that by switching it to the secondary role by pressing R, then S for role secondary, and then C, then M for connect and discard my data, and then Y to confirm that operation. And we see the danger score is quickly cleared out there, and if we drop in the logs, we'll see that the split brain was manually solved. If you need to perform the same action on multiple resources, you can tag them by pressing T after selecting them. We'll tag all our resources that we see in the down state, and then press S, U for state up to bring up those tagged resources. And that should clear out the danger score, and all looks well on our 100 resources across 4 nodes in our Dearbity cluster. Since we didn't really get to see any resyncing happen there, I'll use Dearbity Top to recreate the metadata for R00 on Frodo. This will cause a full resync from Mary. I don't really need to promote R00 on Mary, but it doesn't hurt and adds a data generation to the identifiers tracked in the metadata. And I'll switch back to Frodo and SD for state down. It needs to be in the down state to create the metadata. And once it's downed, I can press MC for metadata create, and then Y to confirm it, which will create the metadata at the end of the block device. And finally, we'll SU for state up so that the device reconnects to the peer and begins negotiating the handshake. Then we can take a peek at the logs and see the generation identifier is full of zeros, which means it's a brand new device and needs syncing. And finally, dropping back to the status view, press I, and we can watch the device get back in sync. And if we go back out all the way to the main view of Dearbity Top, we see that the danger score lowers as the resync progresses until it fully syncs and the danger score is ultimately cleared. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.